Growth in two South Wairarapa towns has ground to a halt, with no new housing developments approved. So for about a year, Martinborough has not been able to connect any new builds to the sewerage network. And now neighbouring town Greytown is in the same boat. Why? Well, because the local wastewater plants are at capacity. Here's Cushla Norman.
In the shadows of the Tararua Ranges and surrounded by fertile soils is Greytown, population 2,700. The main street clings to its past, but behind it there's been a boom of modern builds, although that's about to slow.
I feel very sorry for young people who are coming to the village and want to start a home and we're not allowed to build anything for 3 years.
It's all because Greytown's wastewater treatment plant is chocker. It's servicing 500 more people than it's meant to, and sludge has built up.
I think the desludging is something that's caught everyone by surprise. It shouldn't have. It should have been done on a regular basis, but I don't believe it's been done for quite some time.
When was it last done?
I don't know that it was, to be honest. I've heard the term 30 years mentioned, that it's never been desludged, so that is an issue.
It's forced the council to pause new housing developments. Consents already approved or in train will still go ahead, but a planned 200-lot subdivision is now on hold.
Well, it's probably good. It just keeps the population down.
You want the population to be kept down?
Yeah, it's nice and peaceful here, you know. Why would you want to, you know, have an influx of people?
One word, ratepayers. There's only 7,500 of them across the district. The hefty rates are the talk of the town.
It's breaking down Martinborough, really is.
There are people in town here who are having to close their businesses because of the rates. So we'll end up with no retail in Martinborough. We'll end up being like Aspen. We'll just be priced out of the market.
South Wairarapa had the country's highest rates rise last year at 20%. This year, the average increase is nearly 15.
The way to get our rates down is to increase our population. More people paying rates means less, you know, less the rates have to go up, right? And all of a sudden you go, but we can't actually build any new houses to house people who want to move here. So we've just got into this sort of catch-22 situation. So it's a terrible thing.
In neighbouring Martinborough, it's a similar story. There have been no new subdivisions here in the past year because the wastewater plant can't handle any more connections.
The only way to build a new home in Martinborough is to find somewhere with an existing connection, and that could mean knocking down or removing an old home and building a new one in its place, which is what is happening behind me.
The town's Mitre 10 is noticing the work dry up for builders.
They're doing a lot more sort of repair and fix, renovations, smaller works, non-consented works, fences, decks, those sorts of things, and or looking for work out of the region.
Yeah, you were telling us about someone, they go quite far from
work. As far as Hawke's Bay, yeah, so where the work is. And yes, it's concerning for them because you look down the pipeline of what work's coming and there's not a huge amount.
So this is a 138 square metre home.
A1 Homes is a major builder across Wairarapa.
The Greytown and Martinborough areas probably equate to about 50% of our workload, so it's a significant amount of work that's sort of in jeopardy for us.
How long could this sort of downturn last for builders like yourself?
Well, it'll be at least sort of 2 years after they start issuing consents again. So I would suggest a 4 years minimum we'll feel the impact of it.
So what do you want the council to do right now?
I guess come up with a solution as quickly as possible because, yeah, every month that's consents are not on is going to hurt us.
Desludging, removing the build-up of solids will help the plants get back to an acceptable level. But what the council really needs to do is expand them, which will cost tens of millions of dollars.
How does a small council like yours get the funds to expand and improve its infrastructure?
With difficulty. We have a debt cap, so that's a figure that we shouldn't borrow above. It's difficult to manage the kind of infrastructure growth you need within that. So we would ideally want some kind of extension on that cap to allow us to borrow more. But borrowing comes at a cost.
So where is your debt ceiling at?
Currently, if we don't take any action, we would hit the debt ceiling within probably the next 5 years.
And is that a bit too close for comfort?
Very close for comfort. Not a place I like to be.
Right, good morning, everybody.
This week, the minister leading water reform unveiled a borrowing regime. It encourages councils to team up to form council-controlled water organisations. Then together, they can borrow a lot more, below market rates, from the local government funding agency. The money must only be spent on water. So, can the government's plan help South Wairarapa? Labor says no.
South Wairarapa is under a CCO, and if they can't service the debt they've already got, how the hell can they afford to take on more debt?
The council is part of Wellington Water, along with five others.
They're already in a CCO, and look at the dire straits they're in. So a CCO is the answer.
Well, some of the CCOs we see around the country aren't actually full CCOs. For example, Wellington Water still requires to go back to each council each year and actually ask for money. That's not a financially sustainable approach. That's what we're going to require.
South Wairarapa, shaping up to be a test for the government's water reforms.
You know, there are other councils facing this, and if they're not facing it now, they'll be facing it in the near future. We're probably like the budgie in the coal mine.